This is ridiculous. We can't just keep standing here looking stupid.
There's only one of us there looking stupid, William.
I'm not stupid, Mother.
Kitty, I was talking about William.
Oh. That's okay, then.
Look, how long could we keep standing here like this?
We stay still and be as inconspicuous as possible. Jenny could be anywhere.
Really, Major? Do you think you can get over the war? It has been over for 20 years now.
And who told you it was over? It's never over. It's only over when the last man is left standing, and confounded, I want to be that last man standing.
Father, yeah, you do realise that you are sitting and in a wheelchair.
Yes. Well, so would you be if you stood on a landmine and lost both legs in the blast.
That may be so, Father, but you have both of your legs, and the only reason you're in the wheelchair is because your hip popped out when you fell down the stairs.
You ever think about how I fell down those blasted stairs, William?
There's no need to bring up old stories, Major.
The carpet at the top of the stairs was slightly hitched up. Suspicious! Don't you think, William?
It's like you said, Father. It's old carpet. It can come way out afraid.
Afraid? No. I'm not afraid, William. No, far from it. For I know exactly who is to blame.
You do?
The Jerrys. That's who it is. Those trench-footed sausage munchers. You see, that carpet is German-made. I'm sure of it. And I know he's out there somewhere. Camouflaged against the wallpaper and the tapestries. Damn, Jenny is still trying to get me in his sight. Well, I showed him tonight. Ha! Now look who the last man standing is. I'm sitting, but still, I'm still here. And I'm still winning. You hear me, Jenny? I'm still winning. Everyone, be quiet and still so Jenny doesn't know where we are.
I could have sworn that carpet was from Bangladesh.
Those Bangladeshians are a cunning bunch also. I wouldn't trust them to drop into cahoots with the Jerrys.
Actually, I don't think you can call people from Bangladesh Bangladeshians. I believe they're called Bengalis.
Like the tigers! I wouldn't trust a Bengal tiger. Even if it came close enough to lick me, I'd hit it with a stick. Give it a right royal thrashing. Wouldn't surprise me if those tigers were into the Jerrys.
I'm not sure what's more ridiculous, this conversation or the stupid tableau we seem to be holding onto for no real reason.
Reason? Reason? You don't need a reason to hide from the Jerrys, William. Or tigers or the Bangladeshians. Staying alive in the field of battle isn't ridiculous, my boy, it's survival. Ridiculous would be riding on the back of a rhinoceros in your birthday suit. Through a field of blackberry bushes, balancing a tortoise on your head. Now that would be ridiculous.
I must say, this photographer chappie is taking an awfully long time to take our yearly family portrait.
Oh, is that what we're doing?
I wouldn't trust a photographer. It's probably Jerry doing a recon.
I don't think a rhinoceros would let you ride it. Unless, of course, he was a domesticated one. Daddy, could I get a domesticated rhinoceros?
Certainly not! Thing with them, dropped leavings everywhere. Besides, I don't think I'm trusting rhinoceros.
Father, I do believe they are amazing creatures to hunt.
Oh! Well, perhaps we get one or two for the grounds then.
And a domesticated one for me too, Daddy.
Yes, and one for Kitty, with a saddle.
Thank you so much, Daddy. Was that man who was holding the camera the photographer?
No, that was the vegetable seller. Of course, he was a photographer. A camera would be an essential piece of equipment for a photographer to carry about. Do you not think, Kitty?
Yes, that official-looking man with the moustache.
Moustache? Moustache? I don't trust people with moustaches. Probably a jelly, or worse, Frenchman. Bah!
Father, you do realise that you have a moustache. What could possibly be so fascinating outside of that window that I could stand here and stare at it for at least 20 minutes?
Dolphins!
Dolphins outside of my window!
Well, no, that would be silly. But you have to admit they are fascinating creatures to smile and stare at.
No, I wouldn't trust a dolphin. No, Kitty, you cannot have a dolphin! unless, of course, they're good to hunt.
I will look into it, Father.
I want more animals here at the estate! Ones that stick around and stop running away from all the fireworks!
Fireworks?
The loud bangs I hear by the lake.
Loud bangs! It's the jerrys! Come to finish me off! Quick, batten down the hatches! Will you get my gun? I'll blast them back to Sausage Town!
Loud bangs. Well, this is awkward. Kitty, do you understand what we do here on the estate when we go out with the, hunting dogs?
Yes, you take the dogs for a drive.
What do we take with us when we take dogs for a drive?
The cars?
What do we carry with us?
The big long gunny things.
Yes, the big long gunny things. Normal people call them shotguns. And what would we do with those?
Take them for a drive as well?
Apparently, here on the Huntington estate, we take our dogs and guns for drives.
Hooray, what fun!
No, Petey. We take our hunting dogs and hunting guns hunting, because we are hunters. Kitty, we hunt.
No!
I can't believe she didn't know.
He hunts? Do you hunt the dogs?
I wouldn't trust a dog.
Oh, for duck's sake, Kitty. We hunt ducks, we hunt deer and pheasants. In fact, we hunt pretty much any and every living creature we can get our bullets into. And when I say we hunt, I mean we shoot to kill.
With the big long gunny things?
Oh. So those are the loud bangs that she's been hearing down by the lake. Not the jerrys at all. So I wouldn't put it past them, of course. So that might not be a bad idea, William. You think you could get your hands on some explosives? Keep the jerrys at bay. Might be handy for hunting, too. You know, let off the odd whiz-bang or two, yeah?
Just making a note of it now, Father.
Right! I demand to know right now, just how long has this family been hunting poor, defenseless animals for?
I will let you answer that one, Father.
Oh, about three generations, I would say. But I will have you know that not all animals are defenseless, though, Kitty. Some of them can give you a nasty peck. I've been bitten by a hedgehog once. Nasty little blighters there. Didn't give it a second chance. I had it in a pot for lunch that day. You see, I don't trust anything that I cannot kill.
Kitty, our family have been hunting for over 250 years, starting with your great-great-great-grandfather, Lord Algernon Hunter. Kitty, the Huntington estate has a proud hunting background. What did you think we did here?
I thought we took care of animals.
In a way we do.
Dear, sweet, innocent,
naive Kitty.
The building to the north of the property, past the sheep paddock, is
I don't hear much laughter coming from it. Mostly just cows and whales.
I wouldn't trust an owl. Or a whale. Although, perhaps we could get one to the lake, will you?
Oh, God, this is going to be quite an education. Kitty, the area to the south of the property, where the lake and the woods are...
Oh, that's the animal sanctuary.
Sanctuary isn't a word I'd use.
Well, that's because it's probably a French word. No one in this family will have anything to do with the French. I don't trust them, never have, never will.
But it has to be an animal sanctuary, because it has deer, ducks, and pheasants all roaming around in it. And it's got those tiny little buildings painted green and covered with leaves with a little slot to see out of, so you can watch them frolic.
No, I wouldn't trust frolicking animals. It's a good sign that they're about to attack. Best to take them out quick and fast with a big, long, gunny thing.
I think our kitty has led a very sheltered life. Needs to get out more and explore the world and reality.
I say, Kitty, you could join us in the hunting, come
on. Oh, could I? Wait a minute. As long as no animals get hurt in the taking.
Yeah. The actual shooting of animals is a big part of hunting, I'm afraid.
Oh. Why can't the Huntingtons be gatherers instead of hunters?
She's right, Father. Why can't the Huntingtons be gatherers instead of hunters?
Because we aren't a bunch of namby-pamby, fruit-dandy may-doodles, that's why! We are Huntingtons. We like to kill things.
Well, surely not all of us like to hunt.
Wait, I know for a fact that you like to use a bow and arrow.
Yes, it's called archery, William.
Well, that's hunting, isn't it?
No, because I'm shooting targets and not defenseless animals.
Well, I would think that a target is something that you are aiming to hit. So what's the difference between how you hunt and how I hunt?
My targets are made out of paper, so no animals get hurt.
Interesting. Take a seat, Miss Huntington. And where do you put these so-called targets, Miss Huntington?
I pin them to the trees down by the lake.
She pins these targets to the trees and shoots arrows at them. Members of the family jury, I submit to all of you. Can you not hear those poor, defenseless trees screaming now?
Yes! Yes, I can! But I always hear screaming as the bloody jays.
Don't be ridiculous, William. Trees don't scream, do they, Mother?
Permission to approach the accused, Father.
Sustain. Overruled. Objection. Poppycock. Whiskey! Whiskey!
Meat of any kind.
Oh, boo!
Yes, I'm a vegetarian.
Oh, where did we go wrong?
I don't trust vegetarians.
I know, members of the family jury, how shocking and deplorable this may sound, but unfortunately, vegetarianism isn't a crime yet. However, I find you guilty, Miss Huntington, of being a hypocrite.
I'm not sure what one of those is, but I don't trust them.
Not only do you gather and serve up innocent vegetables, which you devour like some ravenous beast, but you are also a hunter of trees.
Don't be ridiculous, William. I don't hunt the trees. They're just there to hold my targets, which I shoot at, and the arrow goes through the target and into Oh my God, I'm not just a ravenous beast! I'm a monster! Oh, it's worse.
face. She is a little loopy.
Well, really, William, loopy really isn't a nice thing to say about your sister.
Mum, she thought we owned an animal sanctuary?
Innocent mistake. Our property does contain a lot of animals.
Which we kill, often.
Yes, that will show them.
Not to mention she also thought we owned an S. Laughter house.
Yes, well, that was a bit odd. God forbid the man who eventually marries her.
Mother, no one in their right mind would think to marry Kitty. Actually, that makes perfect sense. She'd have much better chance with someone who's not in their right mind. Someone in the loony bin, perhaps.
No, William. No need to be nasty. Our Kitty has as much chance of getting married one day as you. Yes, well, on second thoughts. Look, I think we should keep any future talk relating to hunting quiet around Kitty for a while. Let her settle down a bit. You don't want her becoming too uncontrollable.
And I think she's already a loose cannon.
Oh, that is an idea, William. How about we go down to the lake, let loose with a couple of cannons, eh? Do some real damage, what do you say, William?
Not sure how much of a duck we'd have left after a 20-pound cannon shell. However, we can try.
Yes, Margaret.
Sir Walter Bottoms ready to see the major man.
Oh, well, send him in. Don't dilly-dally about, girl. I haven't seen old Sly Bottom since the last time we discussed the will.
The will?
Sir Walter Bottoms, sir.
Hello, old boy. I'm not disturbing you, am I?
Who are you calling old, you old scallywag? Come on in. Wipe your shoes on the Frenchman. Take a seat. Can I get you a drink?
I could get drinks, Father.
Oh, William, you're still here.
Yes.
Perhaps you could look into some of those purchases for us.
Yes. Let's see. A couple of rhinos, one with a saddle for Kitty. Dolphins, explosives, whiz bangs, fireworks, and a whale, an owl, and a couple of cannons, wasn't it?
Yes, sounds like quite the party, eh, Slybottom?
Surely does. You Huntington sure know how to party, don't you?
Do you remember that party in Morocco in 1932?
Oh, do I? Now, did you ever get to find your testicle?
Oh, yes. I had it put in this bell.
good times.
Yes. Like I always say, never trust the Moroccan midget with a pair of pruning shears.
Right, let's get down to business, shall we? Your will.
Yes, of course. But first, William, why are you in the closet?
I could have sworn I heard a jerry in there, Father.
Really? You don't need my gun?
No need. This one seems to have snuck out somewhere. Scout around the grounds for me and give him a jolly good thrashing, eh?
Good lad.
Jerry's on the estate?
Well, I wouldn't put it past him, you know.
Bloody Jerry's? I'm sick to death of hearing about bloody Jerry's. It's always the same, day in, day out. Jerry did this, Jerry did that, Jerry did the bloody other. It's enough to make me sick.
Well, you seem to have a lot of support here at the estate. That young man of yours, he seems like a fine chap.
Yes, although you did just see him back into a jerryless closet. I'm not sure if the Huntington estate legacy is really in great hands these days, old bean.
Surely you want to keep the father to son succession plan still going ahead as it has for the last 250 years.
Yes, absolutely. It just would be nicer if young William was more,
Reliant?
No.
Strong-willed?
No.
Regal?
I was thinking employed.
Yes, he does come across as a bit of a spawn brass, doesn't he?
And he does rather like Daddy's money.
What I've always said is, the best money you can earn is the money you earn yourself. Blood, sweat and tears. Good old-fashioned days, hard work, never killed anyone.
Oh,
well,
yes.
So I've heard anyway.
Yes, you're absolutely right, Slimebottom. You're absolutely right. But, you know, I'm not sure about that boy. He does test my patience, and I do fear that one day he will be the death of me.
No sign of Jerry, Father. However, I... Oh, my...
See what I mean, Slybottom?
Yes, I do.
Pew, pew, pew.
And who knows, someday soon this could be all yours.
Yes, but when? I mean, of course. What? I can't wait for that day, Sir Walter. Oh, what a wonderful state it is. How much land is there?
Well, as far as the eye can see, my boy.
Good, good. Just while we're talking about it, what's the land and estate worth?
Well, it's history, William. Generations have lived here on the estate. Your father will hand it down to you someday, as his father did to his and his father did to that. You can't put a price on history, William.
Of course. However, if you could put a price on it, what would it be?
Well, the manor's not as ship-shape as it used to be, but it's still damning dull. Well, I reckon if you put this in an auction, it could reach around about
£400,000.
No, my boy. With the grazing land here, it'll be at least £4 million. But there's no way your father will consider selling. I mean, his time on this earth has come and gone, heavens forbid, and you are the owner of this magnificent property, you'll pass it down to your offspring, or to your untimely and unlikely death.
So you're saying, if Huntington Estate is mine, I wouldn't be able to sell it?
Well, yes, you could do anything you want, but you can't put a price on history and family heritage, William. I say, when it comes to family...
Nice of you to come out and drop by, Sir Walter. I hope it wasn't too much trouble.
No, no, not at all, not at all. I had to speak to your father about some reservations. He had about the will, anyway.
Reservations?
Some minor things. Nothing too drastic. Nothing to worry your little head about.
Minor and drastic in the same sentence does sound like a cause of concern, Sir Walter.
Secret that the Huntington Estate... and family is quite large, so your father has decided to, when he's unlikely in time his death happens, that he might change the percentages to within reason.
Within reason? I thought it would naturally come to me, as stated in the family's legacy, father to son, father passes on, heavens
forbid, yes. What I'm trying to say is that he's decided to delegate the percentages to family members of his liking.
His liking? What am I saying? His liking of what?
Well, I think I've given you too much information here already, William. Maybe you should have a discussion with this with your father.
Another drink, Sir Walter. I have a nice batch of spotted.
Well, I do have to get back to the office, but... I've got a driver, so why not? One more for the road. And you say you made this one, William. This is fine whiskey.
So, Sir Father, in the untimely and unlikely death of my father, heavens forbid, who would be the person that receives the highest percentage of the estate?
Well, I'm sorry, William, that's delicate information. I can only share that with ones that are required. This is client confidentiality and all that. You understand, don't you?
Of course, I totally understand, Sir Walter. However, can I just have a quick look at the will?
No, William. I have a reputation to uphold. It's sensitive documentation only to be seen by people legally required to see it.
What if I gave you £50 for a look?
Here you go.
Wait a minute. It says here that the person that receives the majority of the estate is my...
Your mother, yes.
The beach!
Pardon?
The beach. My mother's off to the beach today.
Really? That's a lovely day for it.
So, I have to wait for my mother to... Wait, this can't be right. Next in the line is my...
Your sister.
The cow!
Sorry?
I thought I saw my sister milking a cow out of the paddock.
Really?
I must have been mistaken. Kitty before me.
Well, she is older than you, William, even though you were born fraternal twins.
She was born 6 minutes before me. But does that really count as being older?
I'm afraid it does, William.
So I have to wait for my mother and sister to pass on.
That's not entirely true. There's, your fifth in line.
What? What the?
Frankly, William, I think you've read too much of this information. I have told you too much. Keep it there. If you want to discuss it, talk to it with your father.
Who is next in line?
The housekeeper, Mrs. Spade.
The housekeeper! The bloody housekeeper before me! But wait, no. But she isn't family.
She's your father's sister.
Since when has she been my father's sister?
When she was born?
I meant proper, rich family, not star. How does a mere servant get to be in line before me?
Well, that's not entirely true. There is the gardener.
The gardener? The bloody gardener's before me! Wait, no. Now I know for a fact that he isn't family.
He's married to your aunt.
Since when?
5 years before you were born.
Well, this just isn't so fair. Why am I so far down the list?
Well, it's because your father feels that, because of the situation with, your employment status.
What about it?
You don't have any.
I'm the son of a wealthy estate owner. I don't need to work.
We all have a role to play in life, William. Being involved in employment or in some form of business gives you status. Now, I fear that I've given you too much information at this moment, but maybe this is all this information you need to talk to your father about.
So if I was employed, Sir Walter, would that help my position on the list?
It wouldn't hurt, and I think your father would look favourably upon it.
A job! Employment! It's a salary that makes me tired. If only there's some easier way. But what if... Sir Walter, hypothetically, say the gardener gets killed in a freak lawnmowing accident. I'll naturally go up a notch on the list.
Well, yes, you would, but for that to happen, that would be quite...
Untimely and
unlikely.
Yes, but not impossible. For I do know that this gardener does like a think or two, leading him often to work in a clumsy and foolhardy manner, where, who knows, accidents could happen.
Well, this is the first I'm hearing of this. If this man is behaving in a dangerous or unsafe manner after drinking on the job, this may be... bearing on his legitimacy to be included in the will.
Really? Then I'm sure the housekeeper stealing the silver would also be frowned upon in a legal sense, would it not, Sir Walter?
I can't believe what I'm hearing. In my eyes, theft is theft, be it family or not. I trust you have proof of such a dastardly act.
Proof? I'm sure I can rustle some up for you. Then there's my sister, mad as a hatter, not... I need you a virgin and table and area.
Oh my god, total anarchy! Well, but living a meat-free existence is a terrible and shameful way to live one's life. It's not a crime. Well, not yet, anyway.
She also has a weird thing for trees, if you get what I mean.
Why is she wrapping a bandage around a tree?
I believe it is to heal their broken hearts.
That's just odd.
She also looks around the estate for any wandering unicorns and dragons.
That's loopy.
Loopy, that's the word I'm looking for. Someone who's not in their right mind could possibly be the head of an estate. Could there, Sir Walter?
No, absolutely not.
Exactly what I thought. And then finally, there is my dear, sweet mother.
Well, now, I know for a fact your mother is not a drunk or a thief and is, so far as I know, mad in any way.
You know, I happen to agree with you here, Sir Walter. Apart from the mad bit, you have heard the, dog story.
Oh, yes, the infamous dog that wasn't there story. But that's only happened once, hasn't it?
No, I'm afraid she sees them quite often.
But you have dogs on the grounds, I've seen them.
Yes, we do have dogs here, but not these dogs. Only she sees these dogs, and nobody else sees other dogs.
Well, this is all very troubling information, William. I think I might have to talk to your father again about the will situation.
Yes, I believe you should.
Well, it's a good thing your father's in good health. Strong heart, peak physical condition. Man will be around for years. All this talk about succession really is irrelevant.
Yes, my father is a healthy man. Or healthier than me these days.
Well, you know what could fix that, don't you, William?
Yes.
Good day's hard work.
Yes, working on that. Got a killer of an idea.
Well, Ian, I'd better get back to the office. My driver's probably dozed off by now. If you ever need any help, business-wise or anything like that, you know where to find me. I'll pop by tomorrow and talk to your father about the will and all the stuff you'll be relaying to me.
There's no need for you to come back tomorrow, Sir Walter. Perhaps I'll speak to my father this afternoon. Maybe take him out for a hunt.
A hunt? What a smashing idea! I say, there is nothing like clearing the head from a good bout of hunting, shooting innocent animals. That's the way to spend the day. I say, it's been weeks since I've been on a hunt. I think there's a way that I can tag along, is there, William?
Sorry, Sir Walter. I don't think it's possible. This is something I would like to do to my father, with my father, alone. And like you said, we have been drinking, so I'd hate for accidents to happen. Actually, yes. Why don't you come along? Yes, after all, drinking and hunting really go hand in hand, don't you think?
Absolutely, my boy. I say, why don't you bring a couple of those bottles of your whiskey you made?
Absolutely. As I always say, good hunting, the drunker the better. Say we drive by and pick off the cottage. Say two.
That's splendid. I'll see you at two then.
You do have your own gun, Sir Walter?
Oh, yes, I have an enormous gun. We could shoot an elephant at 100 yards.
We aren't hunting elephants, Sir Walter. However, the elephant in the room.
I'm sorry?
I said I'll see you real soon.
All right, cheerio, bang on!
there you are, William. Still unemployed, I see.
Hello, Mother. Seen any dogs that aren't there today?
One time, I saw a stray dog wander onto the estate, and then it ran away. Now, everybody seems to think I'm seeing things. There was a dog, and then it went home. End of bloody story.
I've seen things too. Radiant blue skies, majestic rainbows, fluttering butterflies in the first spring morning. What a perfect day for a magical unicorn ride around the estate.
You really are loopy.
There's nothing wrong with liking pretty and truly wonderful things, William. They're all around us.
Well, if there was, I'm sure Mother would have seen them.
Like I said, I saw one stray dog.
William, you are so silly. Everyone knows unicorns only show themselves to people who believe in them.
Really, Kitty? Is that true? And do you believe in unicorns?
Of course, William.
And how many have you seen recently?
Well, none as of yet, but it is only spring, so come summer, fingers crossed.
Okay, not loopy, but certainly away with the pixies. Mother Huntington! The Huntingtons, as you know, own four dogs. Is this correct?
Yes, of course.
Could the dog you've seen been one of those?
William, I've told this story over and over again. I know what our dogs look like, and it wasn't any of them.
Mother, do you actually know what breed of dogs we own?
Yes. They're big brown ones.
Breed, not colour or size?
I don't know breeds.
Kitty, please tell Mother the breed of dogs we own.
What, the big brown ones?
Breed. The breed of our dogs, Kitty.
Oh, short-haired Labradors.
Short-haired Labrador. And what was the breed of dog that you saw?
It was a small black dog.
Breed, Mother?
A terrier, maybe?
Last time you told me it was a Dalmatian, and the time before that, a German Shepherd.
I don't know dog breeds, I just know it was a dog. Or
it could have been a dragon that can't take us away on a great and exciting adventure.
Or could have been an African grey, eclectus, possibly a ringneck.
Yes, I guess it could have been any one of those, I suppose.
They're all breeds of parrots, Mother.
Well, maybe I saw a parrot then.
You told everyone he barked at you.
Did I? Well, maybe it was a cough and a squawk that I mistook for a bark.
Or it could have been the growl of a dragon.
Or could have been a meow, or maybe an oink, or possibly a neigh that you heard instead of a bark.
I know what you're trying to do, William. You're trying to make me look like a raving loony.
I think we've room for only one raving loony in this house. Kitty! Can you please stop prancing and snorting about like a demented unicorn?
I'm a dragon, William. Unicorns don't snort. They neigh. They spin their heads like this, making their majestic manes glimmer in the sunlight. And they trot about like this.
I saw you talking to Sir Walter before. What was that about?
We were just talking about stuff.
What's that stuff to do with Will?
Will stuff? I have no idea what you're talking about. Kitty! Can you please stop with the mad cow impressions, please?
I don't think you're allowed to call cows mad anymore, William. That's rude and offensive.
It's a cow! How could you possibly be offensive to a cow? I could call it irritating and annoying, couldn't I?
I think that would have hurt a cow's feelings.
Cows don't have feelings. They merely hamburgers on legs. That is all.
Is that that's your purpose? It's because I choose to live a non-meat lifestyle.
Oh, is that this week's fad, isn't it? Last week you didn't eat butter because you thought it was made from butterflies.
It was you who told me it's made out of butterflies.
I didn't expect you to believe me.
William. All this Will stuff is nothing to concern yourself about, so why don't you go off and play with your toys?
Mother, if you are referring to my extensive collection of models of die-cast soldiers of the 18th century, these are finely manufactured pieces of military history, some you can't even get anymore. I have the largest collection this side of the county, possibly the country. These are not toys, Mother. They are collectible pieces of art.
Whatever you call them, William, go off and play, there's a good boy. Leave the official paperwork and the family matters to the responsible adults.
Who sees invisible dogs?
Actually, you wouldn't see an invisible dog. It would be invisible. You could hear it. It might sniff or snarl or bark.
Oh my God! I'm so over this! I've got things to do!
Would it be...
Or it could be... That's a Peruvian parrot!
If you really must know, Mother, I'm going pheasant hunting with Father and Sir Walter this afternoon.
Hunting? Animals?
Yes, the actual shooting of animals is a big part of hunting. What? Do you want me to go hunting vegetables?
That would be a gathering of vegetables, William.
Where's the fun in that?
Hello? No vegetables get harmed in the taking.
Unless, when they are plucked from the ground, they let out silent screams.
Vegetables don't scream, do they, Mother?
Oh, it's okay, Kitty. The screams are silent, she can't hear them.
That's not true. Is it, Mother?
Say, you could join us on the hunt if you want, Kitty. Taking the dogs and non gunny things, leaving it too.
Okay. What are we hunting for?
I don't expect you to actually hunt an innocent animal, so say you bring along some of your targets and me and Father can throw them in the air for you and you can shoot them pretending they're peg-mache pheasants. How's that?
That sounds all right.
Oh, William, do be careful. Your father hasn't hunted in weeks.
Oh, it's okay, Mother. I'll have him well in my sight.
Wonder how much information Sir Walter gave William about the will changes.
Told him everything.
What?
After bandaging the trees to heal their broken hearts, I came down to the garden to read this really good book about dragons, and I overheard everything.
Okay, Kitty. Tell me every little detail.
Okay, sir, there are fire dragons and ice dragons and dragons.
About the conversation between Sir Walter and William.
Oh, but that was boring stuff. Dragons are so much more interesting. Kitty! Well, as far as I can work out, the father-to-son legacy is no more. You are next in line for the majority of the estate. God forbid Daddy dies.
Yes, God forbid that. But the Huntington legacy, father-to-son, no more. Interesting.
William seemed pretty miffed about being fifth in line.
Fifth in line? That's hilarious. I bet he was steaming. Well, obviously you're after me, but who are third and fourth?
Aunt Margaret and Uncle Jack. Did you know that William didn't know that Aunt Margaret was Daddy's sister, or that she was married to Uncle Jack?
William's not known for his intelligence, my dear, but this information would be making his blood boil.
He sounded really annoyed and quite vengeful.
Really? Interesting.
So, if something unfortunate happens, Daddy, God forbid, you become the majority owner of the estate.
Yes, of course. That's as it should be.
And then if something unfortunate happened to you, God forbid, I'll be next in line.
Yes, well, nothing is going to happen to me.
You could get bitten by one of those invisible dogs, and you'd never know who bit you.
So one bloody dog?
You can get stung by a bee!
What? I'm allergic to bees. How did you know I was allergic?
I didn't, but there is a hive in that tree over there.
Oh my God, get me out of here! To do anything to gain the estate.
Hey, I would think if a family member was to commit a crime such as murder, would that not lead them to be in forfeiture of their entitlement to the estate?
My, Jack, you have been keeping up on your reading. Oh,
yes, I mean, I've had enough experience of the law from one side, time for me to experience the bar from the other. Well, I say it does have its advantages.
Oh, yes. The grass is always greener on the other side. Oh, but the manor would be far more cosier than our current situation.
Here, how long you want me to keep up with this current routine then, eh? You still want me to let those dogs out for the mistress to see?
Oh, yes. Only when she's around. And then I need you to gather them up. I don't want anyone else seeing the dogs that aren't there. 20 years of being my brother's keeper and my sister-in-law's lackey, and I'm sick of it! This should be my estate. It's time for change of leadership, Jack. Things need to be taken care of, and taken care of quickly.
Yeah, well, those stray dogs, they're getting harder to obtain. They really are, but... Oh! I'd be happy to take care of things quicker for you, my love.
What's wrong with your arm?
I mean, you know that I will take care of our problem.
Have you got pink eye or something?
You know that I will take care of business.
I don't understand this winking business.
Oh, I'm happy to kill any of them, all of them off. You just say the word. Ish, all
gone. Ah, no, shush! You'll do no such thing.
But that's what it means, doesn't it? As in nudge, nudge, wink, wink, say no more.
I need the brownies to take care of themselves. If they take each other out, we're in the clear. Understand?
Oh, I see.
I need them not to suspect me at all.
Oh, I see. And then the rightful heir takes her place at the head of the house. Oh, I cracked myself up at this. Get it? Oh, it's a joke, it's a pun, like a play on words, you know? A joke.
Well, it's not very funny, and I don't like jokes. There's no time for humour when there's plans to be made.
There are a lot of these things that we've planned and don't go to plan. What then, love, eh?
Oh, yeah, that's a good point.
Yeah.
They are all imbeciles. Maybe if you follow them on the hunt today. No, hunting's quite a dangerous activity, isn't it? And accidents can happen. That gives me a thought. Do you happen to have any of that weed killer on you?
No, as a matter of fact.
just in case things don't work out, my darling sister-in-law likes to make the tea in the afternoon.
I'll have a good cup of myself.
Don't we all?
Yeah.
But this one, that'll be to die for!
Miserable, Mr. Huntington?
Don't you guys make this all about your animal protecting pocket.
And what if you were a duck? or a pheasant in your current condition. Mr. Huntington?
Well, I definitely wouldn't be able to fly, so chances are I'd fall into the lake and either drown or get scooped up by one of the dogs. Ah, I think I'm finally starting to see your point now, Kitty.
Finally, William knows it's horrible to wound defenseless animals.
Yes, best to take them out in one shot, save from the trauma of being wounded.
That's not what I meant.
Yes, blowing their heads off. That usually works.
This isn't about death or killing. It's about doing the right thing.
Yes. Yes, Kitty's right, you know. Difficult to blow the head off an animal with an arrow. I suppose there's some way to attach explosives to an arrow.
Yes. You could tie it to the end of... No. This is supposed to be a learning experience for us all.
You know, I happen to agree with Kitty in this situation about the learning part. I feel that from now on, we don't take Kitty hunting with us again. All agree? Oh!
Does this hurt?
Yes! Ow! Why? Wait a minute.
To see if it hurt?
It does.
So, every time you mention the benefits of hunting, I'm going to do it again. Until you learn not to.
You wouldn't dare. Oh!
Sorry, William. What's the best thing about being a duck?
How juicy they are to eat. Oh, majestic they are in flight!
See? Isn't that better?
Majestic in flight? What is wrong with you, boy? Not becoming one of those dandy maidens, are you?
Father, she's causing me great pain.
Pain? Pain? You don't know the meaning of the word pain. Try avoiding a Moroccan midget with a pair of pruning shears.
Okay, who would like some tea?
I'll have a whiskey for the pain.
Oh, God! You're the pain! But I'll have a whiskey, please.
Actually, I'll have a small whiskey too, to celebrate my hunts.
Did you hear that, Barbara? Kitty is going to have a drink over me, like I'm some sort of trophy.
What? Like all the trophies we had here on the wall, William? Perhaps we should get you stuffed and mounted for the wall.
And a damn fine shot it was, too.
Thank you, Daddy.
Father, I was the target.
And what a great call you made, William.
Kitty, this goes back to the question of intelligent human beings versus the stupidity of animals. Only stupid animals can get themselves shot by intelligent humans. No, wait, no. Only intelligent humans can shoot stupid animals. No, wait, look, now you're just confusing me.
Confused? Confused? You don't know the meaning of the word confused. Try finding your testicle on a floor full of plum seeds and peanut shells. Now, that is it.
Anybody for tea? What about you, Mavis?
Actually, I think I'll have a whiskey as well.
Oh,
but you went to so much trouble putting the tea bag in the teapot earlier. You're not even going to drink it.
Just the whiskey, Margaret.
No tea. No bodies.
Kitty, you're quite the hunter with that bell of yours.
Oh, thank you, Daddy.
Father, I believe we need to address the elephant in the room.
Elephant? Where? Quick, get my gun.
No! I'm the elephant, I'm the victim here, and you're congratulating Kitty on shooting me.
Oh. Well done to you also, William. You made a fine target.
Kitty shot me. I'm sorry, did you just compliment me, Bob?
No, damn fine job. As far as getting shot by an arrow goes. I don't think I've seen a finer example of, what's the word I'm looking for? Arrow taking. Absorbing.
Catching?
Thudding?
A tea drinking anyone?
Those words don't describe the pain I'm going through here!
Heroic!
Me, getting shot by an arrow. Heroic. Actually, that does sound rather heroic, doesn't it?
Yes, you stopped the arrow from going into a defenseless tree.
Oh, wow. I'm so glad my flesh is good for something. So what, am I a tree guardian now, Kitty?
Steady on, that's sounding a bit tree-huggerish there, William. I think we have enough of those in the family.
How about we have a nice toast to celebrate Kitty's first hunt with a nice cup of tea.
To Kitty.
To Kitty.
Plan. Oh yes.
However, it seems that young Kitty has turned out to be quite the hunter. Family kind?
I don't know that species.
Well, I tried to poison my family with it and it didn't work.
No, of course it didn't. Why would it?
I don't know what I did wrong. Why wouldn't it?
I don't think discretion is either your strong suits, Mr. and Mrs. Spade. Looks like I need to go and see my good friend, Inspector Finchley, down at Shropshire Station. For it seems I've caught myself a couple of attempted murderers. It's my duty as a law-abiding citizen to hand you over promptly before you commit such a dastardly act.
I think, Sir Roger, you have maybe misheard our conversation. My husband and I, we were merely...
Merely...
rehearsing a play.
What?
Oh, yes, that.
Really? You don't seem to come across as thespians.
Yeah, what did you just call us?
Sir Walter, look, Jack and I have been involved in the local theatrical arts society for quite some time, haven't we, Jack?
Oh, yes, we are quite theatrical.
Sounds like a tragedy, this play of yours.
Sorry?
Murder mystery, perhaps? Maybe a comedy of errors. A comedy with no bodies.
No bodies. Mistaken identities. That sort of thing.
And poison that doesn't work.
Oh, hang on now. I'll stop you there. The poison does work. It works just on weeds, not on people.
Jack, can you stop with the hydromatics?
You two are pathetic. Anybody could have walked in. You were lucky it was me.
Oh, yes. You, a law-abiding citizen, my ass. We haven't done anything wrong.
Speaking of doing something wrong, the reason the whiskey one didn't work is I was not informed as to what the true intention of it was.
Did you think your wife was intending to go and kill some weeds?
Well, that is what it's for, isn't it? Weed killing, not people killing.
So, if I was to come out and say, Jack, by any chance, do you happen to have any people killing poison on you that I could poison my family with?
Yeah, well, that would have helped, wouldn't it? Although, well, I get any such poison. I don't have any access to that kind of poison. Only whiskey. Down the cellar, you should see, there's barrels and barrels of the stuff.
Yeah, that's young William's new enterprise. Whiskey making. It's quite secretive about it.
Incidentally, do you happen to know how much weed killer costs, eh? You?
Can we forget about the whiskey-flavoured weed killer for a moment? The things have changed. Originally when the Major was going to die, and then now he's changed it from William and that, so we're going to have to go to Plan B.
Which is?
No. We're going to have to probably dispose the whole family all at once.
Yeah, but that's what I tried to do with the weed killer and the whiskey.
And that leads us back to the multiple bodies to dispose of problem.
Yes, that is a bit awkward, isn't it? That's a big question there. How do you dispose of a whole family and make it look like an accident?
Yeah, I've got another big question for you, Bonsley. I know why she don't like her brother, the Major. What's you got against him then?
It's all about the legacy, Jack, father to son. I never had a father that had me an estate. I had to work for mine. 4 years at law school where I learned to manipulate people and their money. I deserve to have an estate of my own. I deserve to be as rich as these silver spoon legacies. And as for Margaret, well, she's in a family that has a father to son succession. Daughters don't fit into that sort of arrangement.
No, we just get the scraps and the leftovers, hence our current flea bottom situation.
Flea bottom? Not flea bottom house, that derelict shanty on the hill. That's a good 4 miles away, isn't it?
Yeah, well, that's our current living situation, and every day, rain, hail or shine, we have to trudge up to the manor and cater for the Huntington's whims.
But that place is not fit for a dog.
Yes, Betty.
Well, it's got a lovely view of the manor.
Hang on, I thought the legacy situation had changed.
Yes. The Major changed it all due to William's lack of enthusiasm to get work. So let's go back to that original question, shall we? How do we dispose of a whole family and make it look like an accident? Think about that.
Yeah, blow the house up with them all inside. Boom, problem solved.
Yes, that would be a good idea, Jack, but I'm afraid the idea was to leave the house in one piece so we can all live in it and be financially secure for the rest of our days.
Maybe, Jack, on your next hunt, if you could get them all to go, you could perhaps cut the brake lines as a car, and then they could all fiery mess.
Yes, that could work, but we'd need a guaranteed result.
Aha! The Major was talking about explosives earlier.
Jack, I don't suppose you could rig up some form of surprise in the Huntington's car?
Are we talking about a surprise that goes boom?
No, I was thinking of one that played Happy Birthday. Don't you think that'd be lovely surprise?
Especially if it was their birthday. Are we putting some cake?
Just a joke, Jack, just a joke. A bomb will do. No balloons.
What's
our
balloons?
No.
I like those things.
Oh, bloody merry-go-round. wrong with the situation with these stray dogs? Why isn't the mother in the loony bin like that with her daughter?
Dogs are getting harder to obtain. I'm reduced to just leaving stuffed animals and stuff about the place now.
Let's go to the park then!
Oh, I was talking to the wife about going to the park. It was a lovely day. We could get some of that whiskey.
Go to the park and steal some dogs!
What, a child's pet? And have them all sad because you've taken their best friend?
Oh, don't you grow a conscience on me, Jack. You're not afraid of killing people, are you? So get over this dog situation. Fail me again, and this will be the last time.
Last time for what?
I've got friends, Jack, who could take care of you.
Oh, is it? Nice. Take care of us, what we've been after. Take part in a nice house. I like those cakes, if you could bring some of those. Oh, you mean taking care of, that's it.
I don't know if you two understand them. What is wrong with your eye?
That's
I don't think you two understand how serious this is.
Oh, I certainly understand the seriousness of this, and I don't find it funny at all, Sir Walter.
Unless you were poisoning someone's whiskey with more whiskey, because that's pretty funny, isn't it, are they?
I don't know what's going on here, but she did what?
Yeah, that's
she
right.
Put whiskey in her family's whiskey.
More whiskey.
That's rather amusing
in
because
dust, all you're really doing is
making a stronger drink. That is hilarious.
Why, that is so funny.
I'm not surprised you're not funny at all. What we need is now no loose ends. We need to take control of this estate by any means possible. Do we understand?
Yeah. We are totally with you, Sir Walter, as long as we get what's owed to us.
We'll all get what's owed to us, just as long as nothing goes wrong.
I don't think I trust Sir Walter, Jack.
I'm not surprised. He took my whiskey. He's a dirty, rotten thief.
I know, he's a lawyer. It's the same thing.
Trust seems to be something that's in very short supply amongst your family and friends, my dear.
Jack, I think a contingency plan is needed here. Just in case Sir Walter tries to cheat us out of our fair share. Maybe we need to plant a little surprise in his car.
Surprise? Like a cake? Oh, about like a cake, like a souffle. I like those. Maybe some of those Belgian chocolates. I thought, oh, it's going to be a bomb. Surprise, a boring bomb.
Just a bomb, Jack. Just blow up his car. No cake and no chocolates.
I'll tell you, my artistic side is dying in this thing. Can I at least elegantly gift wrap the box?
Sure. Just, here. Use that crissy paper I saw you with fiddling with the other day. Just take care of him.
Is there something wrong with your... Oh, I see.
Just make it look like an accident.
Yeah, no. Yeah, hang on. With a bomb, it's going to be somewhat difficult to make it look like an accident. Here, how about your driver comes down with a sudden illness, veers off the road, and the car goes up in flames, and Sir Walter gets all flame grilled and crispy. Hey, how about that? Dead Sir Walter.
Burning to death. Jack, isn't there any other way you can take Sir Walter out without him suffering excruciating pain?
I'll kill him without pain? Oh, I'm not up with that form of killing, my dear.
No, killing, don't use that word. I don't like it. Taking care of sounds much less bloodthirsty.
Taking care of? Well, how about we,
if you mention anything about a nice way to spend an afternoon, anything about hot chocolate, stronger drink, fair, square, we'll kick you hard up the bollocks.
Jeez. Well, I won't say a thing then. Quiet as a mouse. You'll not hear a thing from me. It'll be like I wasn't even here.
Not here. That's it. What if Sir Walter was to suddenly disappear, never to be seen again?
See? Just kind of vanished from the face of the earth. Because there's many places on this estate here where you can hide something like a forest, or the slaughterhouse.
That's brilliant. That sounds like the perfect plan. Make it happen.
I will. Shall we kiss then?
No! No!
It's been so long.
That sounds like an awfully good play they were rehearsing.
So tell me, William, you really are making whiskey in the cellar?
Well, yes, Father, but before you say anything,
is
I'd
it
like
any
to say
good?
That I haven't told you because... Sorry.
Is it any good?
Well, it's what we've been drinking for the past 5 years.
This is your whiskey, William?
Yes, Father.
How are you funding this little operation?
Well, the costs are minimal, Father. We've all the resources right here on the estate. Still, I built from an old silo that was used on the property. Wheat maize from the upper field, spring water from the lake, collecting and boiling it in an oak barrel, aging and flavouring whiskey ready for bottling.
Sounds like awfully hard work there, would it?
Well, it's like a well-oiled machine, Father. The more you put in, the more you get out of it.
Spoken like a true businessman.
This is something I did as a hobby, Father, for the Huntington Estate.
Huntington State Whiskey. I like the sound of that.
Like I said, I haven't told you because... What?
I said I like the idea of a Huntington Estate Whiskey. How does it sell
it? I don't sell it, Father. I just make it for you and family.
But, William, this is... Fine whiskey. I mean, why don't you sell it? Make your own empire out of it.
I'm not that clever in business, Father. I wouldn't know where to start.
William, you just told me how you've been making whiskey for the past 5 years. Fine whiskey. I think you're much cleverer than you think you are, and much wiser than I thought you were. Maybe, Sir Walter could point you in the right direction. He's good with business and the finance side of things.
But the Huntingtons just hunt.
Yes, but we drink too.
We could turn the ice laughter house into a whiskey distillery. Whiskey's always bound to bring more laughter.
But Kitty, all those wheat and maize, what will your tree friends think of you?
It's wheat and maize, William. Pretty much weeds.
Huntington Estate Whiskey. It does have a nice ring, doesn't it?
Yes, it does. Yes.
Do you think this is a feasible idea, Father? Making whiskey and selling it?
Oh, it's a brilliant idea, William. But do you happen to have any older vintages or something stronger, perhaps?
I actually have a batch that's been oak soaked for the past 3 years. I'm about to bottle it today.
Oh, well, bring it up here and let's have a taste, shall we?
Go get a bottle then.
I'll bring up the whole barrel, I say. Let's make a day of it, eh? What?
I'll help you, William.
Help me, but you hate me.
Why would I hate you? My fine target.
I believe the term is heroic, wasn't it? Oh!
Come on.
Well, I might pop along to the kitchen and see what Margaret's got planned for dinner tonight.
You're not going to cook, are you?
Me? Cook? No, that's what we have servants for.
Well, I wasn't sure if my sister likes the idea of being called servant.
Well, she does live in servants' quarters.
What servants' quarters?
Flea Bottom House.
Oh, what the dickens is she doing living in that derelict squalor? That's miles away from the manor. That place is not fit for a dog.
Well, she has been there since... Ah! A dog! A new dog! Here! Oh, my God! I can't look!
What are you on about, you blasted woman?
It's happening again! Look! Look over there!
You know, between you and Kitty, I'm unsure who's the loopiest.
That dog right...
trying to sneak away.
Well,
come to take me out, have you?
Well,
you seem to have lost your German accent there, Jerry.
Oh, Achtung, Herr Major von Huntington.
So, you've come to shoot me in the back like the backstabbing sausage scum that you are, eh?
I'll tell you where it was. I know it was here. I'm telling you, that dog was right there. Jack, what are you doing? That's the dog I saw. Why are you holding a gun?
Where is he?
Well,
where's Jerry? He was here just a minute ago. He was going to kill him.
That's right, Major. He was. I saw this fella outside. He was looking all strange like he was. He was goose-stepping and sitting all over the shop. I thought his behaviour was quite odd.
Oh, yes. Sounds like Jerry. Very odd and sneaky. Sounds very plausible. Do continue.
Oh, that's right, Major. And I put chase to him, and he came inside the manor, he did. He came in the drawing room.
Sausage scum!
Yeah, oh, you know, I'm so convinced. A strudel, stuff flying everywhere. And I put chase to him.
Yes, good for you. Good for you, Jack!
Yeah.
Where is he now? I'd like to lay my boot into him.
Yeah, well, I think my thrashing got the better of him, I did. And he fled, laid a hose and flying all over the shop. There was, I got him with the butt of my gun.
Good for you,
and
Jack.
And the dog?
Yes, the yellow-bellied scum.
Scum.
And the dog?
Oh, what dog?
That dog you're holding.
Oh, this dog. Well, this dog, Margaret, this dog. Tell her about this dog.
I think what Jack is trying to say is that for the last couple of weeks we've noticed some dogs roaming around the property, and we've been going around every couple of days to make sure that they're not doing any damage.
I've told you all I've seen these dogs, and not one of you believes me. See, I'm not mad, I'm not loopy, I've been telling you all along. I saw these dogs.
Now hang on, you two live at the top of that hill in that derelict shanty. That's a fair walk to the estate. No, I won't stand for it. Two dedicated servants, loyal family members, I should say, don't deserve to live like that. Especially ones who care about the safety and well-being of this family. No, from now on, you two will be staying in one of the umpteenth rooms that we have here in the manor, and I will not take no for an answer.
What's going on here? We haven't a pie?
Look, William, a dog. I told you I saw dogs. Do you see the dog?
Yes, but doesn't feel like a real dog.
Yeah, well, that's because he's... got rabies!
Ah!
Oh, no, just get rid of him.
Well, what a bizarre day it's been. It all started when Slybottom came round and, actually, speaking of Slybottom, where is he? I haven't seen him since the hunt. I think I need to tell him that I'm going to make some drastic changes to the weather.
Drastic changes?
Well, I feel I've been somewhat foolish about my assumptions with this family. especially you, William. However, I'm not going to reinstate the legacy clause. I am, in fact, going to end it for good. Instead, I think it only fair that everyone in this family has an equal share of the Huntington estate. Or should I say, the Huntington Estate Whiskey Distillery. Hey, William?
Father, I don't know what to say.
How about hooray?
Hooray! Hooray!
So, all we need is Sir Walter to be here to organise the paperwork. Where is he? He seems to have disappeared off the face of the earth.
Aunt Margaret and Uncle Jack seem to be acting rather peculiar this evening, don't you think?
It's probably because of the play they've been working on.
Play? That is even a theatrical type.
Not sure if it's a murder mystery or a comedy.
Well, I think going on Margaret's joke-telling skills, we're all guaranteed it's
not a
comedy.
Or a tragedy, I'd say.
So, is it me, or are we back where this all started?
Yes, except I was here, and Mother, you were here, and Father, you were... Father?
He's dead. Major's dead.
So he's dead?
But things are working out for us.
He got what he always wanted. One happy family. William, you now have your own whiskey-making empire. Father would be proud of you for that. He also gives you status. Mother, now we all know you're not going crazy over seeing dogs that weren't there, because all along, they were there.
Yes, thank goodness for that. Even I was beginning to think I was going loopy. The Major loved dogs. In fact, I've just finished making lists for him. We should get more dogs. We've got plenty of room on the estate for them. Maybe we could be a sanctuary for stray dogs.
And for any visiting dragons or unicorns? Just kidding. Anyway.
Normally I'd make a snark remark about your bloody ideas, Kitty, but I think I have to agree with you. So let us be the Huntington Estate Whiskey Distillery and Sanctuary for Wayward Dogs, where the seasonal unicorns and dragons can pop by also. Oh! He's making arrows, Kitty!
So, why don't we make the Huntington Whiskey label a unicorn riding a dragon?
Don't be ridiculous, Mother. Everyone knows it would be a dragon riding a unicorn, right, Kitty?
Yes!
Hello, Sir Walter. Why are you wet?
Well, he crashed his car.
No, he went swimming. He crashed his car in the lake.
Sounded like a good idea at the time.
Right, well, just to let you know what's going on, the Huntington Estate will now become Whiskey Distillery. It's a sanctuary for stray dogs.
Okay.
And for any visiting dragons or unicorns?
It's depending on the season.
Of course.
Oh, my father died.
What?
Dragons and unicorns? What? Next thing there will be fairies and leprechauns down the bottom of the garden. All you people start raving mad.
Mad! No, back of French heavens, you are, you are. Oh, I must have nodded off. I say, Snowbottom, good to see you. You were... Why are you wet? Long story.
Oh, which you can tell us another time. It appears that the Major has decided to change the legacy again, and he's going to give us all the family an equal share. And I'm thinking that that would require some very special paperwork, which would get you a substantial fee.
Yeah, I know exactly what legal paperwork for this sort of situation will require the family lawyer, me, to receive quite a large sum of money for the delicate paperwork, you understand?
Yes, that goes without saying, Slybottom. incidentally, William would like to know if you'd like to help him out with his whiskey-making empire. What do you say, Slybottom?
Well,
you want to team up with the lad, help him make millions?
Sure, I can have that paperwork done up by the morning.
Excellent.
Well, it's all working out, you know. Here, let's have some drinks then. Yeah? I think we should celebrate this momentous occasion. Everything working out with some wheat or whiskey. Here we go.
To Loopy Sisters.
The brothers who make great targets.
And heroic targets, thank you, Kitty.
A place to finally call home.
Here. Because when it comes to family, we should all be well taken care of.
Did he wink?
No, Jack, he didn't wink.
What was that, Bug?
It's just telling a joke.
State Whiskey Distillery and Sanctuary for Stray Dogs.
Where any visiting drivers or unicorns can pop by also.
I say, William, if any of those dragons or unicorns do pop by, I think they might be good to hunt.
I think with the Whiskey Distillery and Dog Sanctuary to run, you might be a bit too busy to hunt.
But Huntington's? Not hunt. Whatever will I do?
I've got the perfect role for you in mind, Father. Quality control.
Excellent. That sounds like a splendid way to spend an afternoon, yes? Cheers!
Cheers!
Cheers.
I wrote this 5 years ago. We tried to do it on this bizarre year 2020, and this pandemic came along and ruined everything. We tried again in 2021. Play was recast and people moved on and all this, so we finally got it on stage. So I'm glad you come along. This was our last show, final show for tonight. But this is just not the only people that take part in the show. Can I get all the guys backstage to come up? Round of applause for backstage. Appeals to you and you want to join the theatre group, please talk to one of the members here. I haven't mentioned one cast member that I've worked with for the 20 years I've done with the theatre group, been in every one of my shows, never forgets a line, the drinks cabinet. Alright, we don't have to get you to promote it anymore because this was the final night. We're going to come out and say thank you, so one more round of applause for the cast.